Just across the Hudson River from New York City is Newark, New Jersey, where tonight at the Prudential Center, Game 2 of the 2012 NHL Stanley Cup Playoffs was played, and again it went into overtime. And Jeff Carter is the hero for the Kings. They win for the second straight game in overtime, 2-1 over New Jersey, and the Kings have a 2-0 lead in this Stanley Cup Final. And the Kings now on the road this playoff year, 10-0, and they deserve that overtime. They had 11 shots in the overtime.
You know, early in the game, kind of the normal situation in a road game where you have to weather a storm, and the Kings did that. Jonathan Quick was on top of his game early. As the game went along, New Jersey certainly played a much better game, and overall, Bob, it was a much better game to watch. The skilled players did have some time with the puck. They were getting some space. Again, you know, you don't want to shut it down so much where there's no scoring chances. Tonight, there were scoring chances. But into the overtime, it just kept going for the Kings. It was time and time again. When the Devils had a chance in overtime, it was one at a time. When the Kings had chances, two or three at a time, and the last goal. The reason the Kings picked up Jeff Carter, because of his wrist shot. Enough said on that one, because he pulled the trigger on the wrist shot.
He sure did. Here's the highlight, the game-winning goal.
Well, you have the traffic there with Penner, so there's the first opportunity by the Kings. Then you have Carter circling the wagon, so to speak, and then he shoots back against the flow. Watch the traffic. Richards, look at Martinez, Evan. Look at the defenseman. Carter will go by a defenseman, so the Kings were aggressive. That's the one thing the Kings have done all season long since Daryl Sutter has taken over as the coach. So the first one doesn't work. Carter keeps going. There's Martinez, sets a little pick. A little bit of a front net presence there by Penner too. Dustin Penner had a much better game in this game, game number two. Back against the flow. You're going one way, you pull the trigger the other way. Look at this, head up. Doesn't even look at the net. Does not even look at the net. And Brodeur sees it, but he can't feel it. He can't reach out. Brodeur goes down, look at this, paddle down flat, but he cannot follow the puck when it gets a little bit up, and it's about a foot off the ice. That's all that's needed. The Kings certainly celebrate. The Kings deserve the overtime. They had the play going in the OT this game against the New Jersey Devils. So it's one of those games where the Kings, even when the Devils tied it up in the third, Bob, it wasn't because the Kings were backing off. The Kings were aggressive. I know the goal came 3 minutes into the third period, I believe, to tie it up. But it was the first time the Devils had the puck in the offensive zone, so there was no case of the Kings backing off. Much better tempo all night, much better speed, but the Kings find a way to grind you. They grind you down. In that OT, New Jersey couldn't keep up.
I was so excited, forgot to say this, Bob Miller along with Jim Fox.
Are we?
But we just wanted to talk about that game-winning goal. It came with 6:15 left to go in the overtime. First time in 61 years that games 1 and 2 in the NHL Stanley Cup Final was decided in overtime. The other time, 1951, Toronto against Montreal. All five of those games went into overtime, and Toronto won that series 4-1. But the Kings in game two of the playoffs this year have dominated. They're 4-0. Look at the goals for and the goals against. The power play, had chances tonight. Didn't score on the power play. Look at the penalty kill. Perfect. And look at that bottom line there. Time trailing. They have not trailed in the second period in this playoff year.
You have to make adjustments through any series, and that's what the Kings are doing. Their entire coaching staff and then the players taking it on the ice. The penalty kill is the big number here, especially tonight. Again, there were times early in the game when New Jersey felt they were going to have that opportunity, and actually early on in the game, the first two power plays for the New Jersey Devils, New Jersey was coming on and they were going and they're gaining the momentum. When Jersey got the power play, the Kings shut it down so much, I felt those penalty kills gave the Kings not a change in momentum, but a feeling of security, a feeling of control, then they can go on from there.
The Kings scored first in the game, and what a goal it was by defenseman Drew Doughty. Let's take a look at that.
Well, the first thing with the goal by Doughty, it's the read on the play, his escapability. Watch this. Pressure, first man, turn, head up. Now he senses that the Devils are in a change. The sense is what leads to the goal. The skill is what scores the goal. When Doughty figures out the Devils are flat-footed, look at this. Look at the defenseman backing up. That's the defenseman right there, Salvador. He's already to the dots. But that play is started by Doughty well up the ice. Again, it's about the read. We've talked about it so many times with Drew Doughty. He does have that sixth sense on the ice to understand when the other team is on their heels. And when he turned around and looked up ice, he spotted the fact that the Devils were in a change. And from that point on, he says, I'm going to go, and I'm going to go hard. Now, on the release, The pull and drag move to change the angle. Used the defenseman, but changed the angle on Marty Brodeur. He couldn't follow it across. Snap, pucks in the net.
With the Kings win tonight, they are just the fourth team in NHL history to win 10 road games in a playoff season, and they are the first one to go 10-0 on the road. The Kings win it in overtime, 2-1. They have a 2-0 lead in this series. Let's go down to Patrick O'Neill.
All right, Bob, thank you very much. With Alec Martinez, you were on the ice for that game-winning goal, a tremendous play by Karts. I know you were open too, but he took it, he was going to shoot it, and he scored. What a play.
Oh, yeah, for sure. The puck popped out in the neutral zone there, and I saw Kartsy there. He was presenting for a pass, and so I just gave him a little quick up, and he turned it up and ended up wheeling around and around a little bit more, and then he was able to put her home short side, so it was a great play by him.
Obviously, two more to go, but to stay unbeaten on the road here in New Jersey, to take this one again in overtime. How's that feel, and how's the team feel right now?
Oh, it feels good. Obviously, we're happy with getting two wins here, and it's a really tough place to play. And, you know, the Devils are a great hockey team, and, they really played well tonight and played hard. And, fortunately, we were able to weather the storm and bury one in overtime.
And your goaltender, again, I mean, on both sides, obviously, Marty over there doing his thing, but Quickie saved you guys there.
Yeah, I mean, Quickie is nothing's changed with him. He's been doing that all year, and he's an unbelievable goalie, and gives us a huge boost of confidence with him back there.
Best of luck. Good job. Still plenty of work to go, and we'll see you in L.A.
Awesome. Thanks.
Okay. Alec Martinez. Guys, back to you, all right?
Now, Patrick, on that game-winning goal, I know it's kind of a small thing, but it's about the attitude the Kings take, even in overtime. When you're maybe more conservative, no. The Kings keep going. It was Alec Martinez that jumped in looking for a pass. It wasn't there. Stayed in. Kind of set just a little of a pick. Just reached out. And Carter went in behind Martinez. Now, that's a defenseman in overtime looking, sniffing down near the goal. He didn't score it, but that attitude is so prevalent now with the LA Kings. They want it. They go after you. They're not going to back off.
Kings have never been this close. 19 years ago, won the first game, but lost the second. Now, two wins away from the Cup and coming home. We'll have a lot more from here at the Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. Jeff Carter gets the game winner in overtime. Kings win it 2-1. We'll be right back.
We've seen it before. We see it again. The Stanley Cup, LA Live, right outside of Staples Center. The Kings will be coming back home, of course, Monday, Wednesday, games 3 and 4. If you want to see the Kings play in the Stanley Cup Final, only one way to guarantee tickets. That's by placing a deposit on season tickets for next year. Information how to purchase, visit lakings.com/playoffs.
Kings win in overtime for the second consecutive time here in New Jersey. And the Kings, we talked before about Kings of the road, and they certainly are still undefeated on the road.
They have that confidence with the balance. They have now the depth, especially at the center position with Kopitar and Richards. I think Kopitar tonight was excellent again defensively. He was quiet offensively along with Dustin Brown, but even as the Kings went into overtime, I can count maybe five times where Dustin Brown was getting contact. Williams, Kopitar keeping alive. As the game went along, those guys got better.
You mentioned Justin Williams. We're going to hear from him right now. He is downstairs live with Patrick O'Neill. Patrick.
Bob, Jim, thanks very much. Justin, congratulations. A big win again in overtime. Tell me what you think was the difference here.
Well, I think probably both games probably could have gone either way. You're in overtime. You never know what's going to happen. And we had another hero step up tonight, just like we have all playoffs. And tonight, Jeff scored a big goal for us.
Yeah, that was a huge goal. He took it in. He got it again. Had a couple D guys open and just buried it, avoiding the glove of Brodeur.
That's what he is. He's a game breaker. And that's what he came here for. And I don't think he scored a bigger goal than that one.
All right, so you're going back home up 2-0. You guys have not lost on the road. It's definitely a really exciting time for the LA Kings. And you guys going back home to play Monday for game 3.
Certainly, we're excited. But at the same time, I think the taste is going to drive you a little bit harder, but it's not time to relent. It's not time to be passive. We know what happened last year in the Stanley Cup playoffs, who won the first two games and who ended up winning the series. So now's the time to drive hard at it. We're excited to play in front of hometown fans.
You guys pretty evenly matched, do you think, these two teams on the ice?
Well, sure. We got a quick turnaround here for game two and game three, and we're excited with that. It's not a long break, so the best prepared team will win the next one.
Well, I'm going to go let you hydrate. Great effort tonight, and I look forward to seeing you in L.A. for Monday.
Great, me too. Thanks.
Okay, Justin Williams, guys, back to you.
Well, Patrick, first thing to say, Bob, the conditions were much better tonight. We talked about the game. Maybe the ice conditions were better because it was colder in the arena. Maybe the humidity goes away and the ice gets a little bit better. The players can move it around. Justin Williams, one of four Kings players to win a Stanley Cup. The Kings have four other players that went to the Stanley Cup final. That's a nice little mix. You have the guys who know how to get there and the guys that are hungry to get there.
There was no doubt the humidity was a lot lower in this building tonight. Jarrett Stoll was outstanding in the second period and faceoffs. He was winning them cleanly every time, just about. And he had this to say to the group of reporters downstairs.
Balance too. Huh? There was turnovers on both sides. That's the game. One less turnover maybe, or one less great play, and that's the difference in a hockey game. Quickie played great to hold us in it when we needed him, and some big saves again. Fire drill was on a couple times in our zone, but we withstood it. We were positive on the bench. We were composed and as much as we could be, and found a way to win again.
How does it feel to go back 2-0?
Feels great, but you don't win anything with two games. You got two more to go, and those are definitely going to be the toughest. We all know that from experience this year in the playoffs. So, happy with the two wins for sure. But we got to get some water in us, get some food in us, and get on the plane.
That was a great play by Carter.
Two games, four rounds in a row. How much does that make?
Yeah, it's kind of weird, but great, but weird, and we got to take advantage of it. We got to take advantage of the opportunity. We're going back to our home ice, to our home crowd, and we got to play simple, composed, and smart. Not too fancy out there, and hopefully try and get a winning game three.
A tremendous play by Carter.
Another one of those games, Bob, from Jarrett Stoll. Don't underestimate his value tonight. We talked about it when we were watching the game together. The energy he brought. He was so effective on the faceoffs as the game went along, but just the energy and getting on pucks and keeping pressure on the opposition. Third line center, didn't play like a third line center tonight. He was all over the ice doing whatever it took. Make contact, win faceoffs, make passes, just keep the pressure on.
Fourth consecutive series this playoff year that the Kings have won the first two games on the road. And they have a 2-0 lead now in the Stanley Cup Finals over the New Jersey Devils, headed home to Staples Center for Monday and Wednesday. The Kings win tonight in overtime for the second game in a row. Jeff Carter gets the win. Kings win it 2-1 in overtime. And we've got a lot more coming from here in Newark, New Jersey.
Two games down, Kings looking to go back to Los Angeles Staples Center, back to game one. The Kings pulled it out in overtime. Great forecheck by Nolan. Twice, separates Reed from the puck. Frazier backs off. Catch, release, one motion, 1-0 Kings. The Devils, who played a much better game as the game went along, get kind of a lucky break here, but get the puck through, that's important. Bounce off the goaltender, bounce off Voinoff, the chest, and look at this. Just goes and goes and goes, and the Devils tie it up 1-1. But of course, in overtime, the Kings and the skill take over. Took a while to get it out along the boards. Doughty to Williams. Smart pass. Kopitar fake. Get the goaltender to flinch. Then use the patience and the reach. And the Kings win game one, 2-1 in overtime. That will sound like a carbon copy because that's exactly the score in tonight's game, game number two. Into overtime. Carter wide. Penner at the net. Martinez was involved. But around, look. He didn't even look at the net. He just looked away, shoots against the flow. The wrist shot is what Jeff Carter is known for. Ryan Carter scored a goal for the Devils. Jeff Carter, though, gets the big one. And the Los Angeles Kings, carbon copy, 2-1 in overtime.
And the Kings this playoff year now are 14-2 as they are 2 games away now from winning it all as they head back home. So let's take a look at the schedule coming up. In these playoffs, as I said, the Kings head back to Staples Center now. We'll be playing on Monday night and Wednesday night. And then if there is a game five, it would be a week from tonight here in New Jersey. A game six would be on Monday, June 11th, back in Los Angeles. And if there's a game seven, June 13th. Daryl Sutter has continually said they don't give you anything for winning 3 games. They don't give you anything for winning 2 games, even though the Kings are up 2-0. Let's hear what he had to say after this game tonight.
It's a terrific team game. Great performance by Quick, but it takes 2 plays of individual skill to get the 2 goals.
Yeah, I think we weathered storm first period and withstood a pretty strong forecheck. Made some mistakes. Our goalie made some saves, same as theirs.
How would you say your team played tonight?
Pardon?
How would you assess your team's play tonight?
I thought it was a hell of a battle. What'd you think? Were you happy with how our team played tonight?
I mean, do you
think it's building? You just finished playing the team that had the most home wins in the Stanley Cup playoffs. That played hard. Sorry.
Can you talk a little bit about Jeff Carter and the winning goal and how you saw it transpire?
Good to see him score. Right, Marty made some highlight saves tonight against good shooters, so it was good to see him score. And I think it was, I don't even know if he saw it. There's probably a Penner and who it was, even from the bench, it was hard to see where it was going.
At the beginning of overtime there, the Devils got a lot of chances. They had a couple surges. What was key for your team besides the great play of Quick to keep the puck out of the net?
I think both teams had a lot of chances and surges.
Coach Sutter, since you acquired Jeff Carter, he's played at high levels all throughout his career coming up. Can you describe the level of poise that he's shown out there tonight?
He's a goal scorer. You know what? You're counting on him to score a big goal.
Just on Doughty's goal.
Yep.
Is he trying to be more?
Hey, great play. You know what? It's a 200-foot play, right? It's one of them coast-to-coast things that, you know what, you'll look at a lot of times. Win or lose tonight, that's a great play.
Certainly is a great play by Drew Doughty. Starts from the read, then the skill takes over, then he uses the defenseman as a screen, pull and drag, all those things. With Jeff Carter, again, we talked about it, Bob, with Darryl, keeps it pretty simple. He's goal scorer. We expect big goals from him. The Kings got one tonight. Dustin Penner was on the ice. I thought he had a much better game tonight. Mm-hmm. He was involved a lot more. He was keeping the puck alive a couple times. And, you know, so many guys, we can talk about it. Once again, there's so many different guys that have stepped up for the Kings. And another guy not to forget, and I know I've done it before, I've taken him for granted, Jonathan Quick tonight. He made two saves where he was lightning fast with the reflexes. Didn't necessarily see it. Change of direction, makes the stop.
And let's not forget, with about 7.2 seconds left, Kovalchuk hits the crossbar, and that would have won it, but it hit the crossbar and went out of play. Kings win it, and they celebrate off the bench. 2-1 Kings. Back with more in a minute. We are back here in New Jersey, where the Kings have won in overtime 2-1 to take a 2-0 lead in this series. And I think you could tell by the press conference of Darryl Sutter, his demeanor and how he keeps things low-key and focused simply on the next game.
That's a big part, too, Bob, on the bench. That same type of demeanor with the Kings, and we've seen it all playoffs long. And, you know, it's rubbing off on me. I'm watching. And in the third, I'm not getting nervous. There's a calmness on the bench. You know, it's tough out there. It's a tight game. But the Kings have proven so many times before that they have an understanding of what they want to do, and then they go out and execute it. Of course, when you play in the NHL in the Stanley Cup Final, it's not always going to work because the other team's a pretty good team. But Darryl Sutter takes control, follows through on the bench, follows through on the ice, and the Kings can execute. Drew Doughty, 200-foot goal. What about a 200-foot game? We're going to take a look at a couple of plays he made tonight defensively, controlling the gap. That's so important, too. You go back into the first period. Looks like a simple play. Look at that right there. Standing up at the blue line against Patrick Eliash. I thought Eliash might be the best player tonight for the Devils, especially early. Here's Parisi along the boards. Bang! Doughty takes him down. That gap control was so important. One was at the offensive blue line. One was at the defensive blue line. And in a lot of hockey games, if you can control the blue line, if you can control the blue line, then you can control the game. That's exactly what happened tonight with Drew Doughty. You saw a couple of instances right there. With the puck, without the puck, it doesn't matter. He controlled the blue line.
You weren't nervous? I was. I'd show you my fingernails if I had any left.
I wasn't nervous.
Kings win it 2-1, and we are going to hear from Dustin Brown, the captain right now. He is with Patrick O'Neill.
Dustin, huge win for you guys to go 2-0 and go back home, I believe. Big play by Carter.
Huge goal, huge momentum for us coming back, and we've been in the situation 3 times before. I said this before. We've worked hard to get ourselves in this situation. Now it's responsibility and awareness to take advantage of going back home.
Yeah, big key for you guys when you go back for game 3 after playing these guys so tightly in 2 games.
Yeah, I don't expect it to be any different. Again, this is from a forecheck standpoint. They're forcing our guys, wingers, defensemen, turnovers, a lot of turnovers tonight for us. And it's part of the game and battling through it and finding a way.
Another hero tonight, Carter, what a play.
Yeah, I mean, I get to your emotions. You don't really remember. I just remember him coming around the top of the circle, finding a way to get in the net. So you don't really remember him.
Yeah. Dustin Brown, the King captain, ready to go back home to Los Angeles with a 2-0 lead in this series. It'll be Monday at 5 o'clock at Staples Center. After the game, we'll have Kings Live on Prime Ticket right after the game on Monday night. So the Kings get a big win here. For Jim Fox and Patrick O'Neill, this is Bob Miller. Thank you very much for being with us tonight. In overtime, the Kings win on a goal by Jeff Carter. 2-1, Kings lead the series 2-0. We'll see you at Staples Center on Monday. Good night, everyone.